In this video, I will explain in detail how the derivative of cosine x becomes negative sine x using the limit definition of derivative, also known as the first principle. We'll use this formula to demonstrate how the derivative of cosine x equals negative sine x. Anyway, shall we begin? We'll prove why the derivative of cosine x is negative sine x, and to do that, we'll use the limit definition of the derivative shown here in green. Let's first define f of x as cosine x. Then f of x plus h becomes cosine x plus h. And to expand it, let's briefly review the compound angle formula for cosine. We know that cosine x plus y can be expanded as cosine x times cosine y minus sine x times sine y. Applying this formula, we can expand cosine x plus h as cosine x times cosine h minus sine x times sine h. Now, let's substitute f of x and our expanded f of x plus h into the limit definition of the derivative formula. The numerator becomes cosine x times cosine h minus sine x times sine h minus cosine x. And the first and the last terms have the common factor of cosine x. Factoring out cosine x, the numerator becomes cosine x times cosine h minus 1 minus sine x times sine h. Now, let's express the expression as two fractions. As h approaches 0, the limit of cosine x times parentheses cosine h minus 1 over h minus sine x times sine h over h can be obtained. If we expand the limit and eliminate the square brackets, we have the expression as the limit of cosine x times cosine h minus 1 over h minus limit of sine x times sine h over h. Looking at the limit condition where h approaches 0, and this limit is independent of x, we can bring out the functions of x, cosine x and sine x, in front of the limit. So it becomes cosine x times limit of cosine h minus 1 over h minus sine x times limit of sine h over h. If we know the values of the limits indicated in orange and green, we can determine the derivative of the cosine x. In a previous video, I explained in detail why the limit of sine h over h becomes 1 using a diagram. If you are curious, please click on the link on the top right corner to learn about it first. If the green expression becomes 1, then we can simplify the expression further. Cosine x times limit of cosine h minus 1 over h minus sine x times 1. We are left with the value of the limit indicated in orange, and let's find out how it can be simplified. We'll multiply the numerator and the denominator of the limit of cosine h minus 1 over h by cosine h plus 1. The numerator becomes cosine squared h minus 1, and the denominator becomes h times cosine h plus 1. By utilizing the well-known trigonometric identity, sine squared h plus cosine squared h is 1, we can replace cosine squared h minus 1 with negative sine squared h in the numerator. So the numerator of the limit becomes negative sine squared h, while the denominator remains unchanged. Then expressing the numerator as sine h times negative sine h as a product, the limit becomes sine h over h times negative sine h over cosine h plus 1, and you will revisit the limit of sine h over h that we saw before. Since that value is 1, we can simplify this limit expression to negative sine h over cosine h plus 1. As h approaches 0, this limit evaluates to negative 0 over 1 plus 1, which is simplifies to 0. Therefore, in the expression for the derivative of cosine x, cosine x times limit cosine h minus 1 over h minus sine x, the first term becomes 0, leaving us with negative sine x. Hence, the derivative of cosine x is negative sine x. Today, we examined how the derivative of cosine x becomes negative sine x using the definition of a derivative. If you want to learn more about the differentiation of trigonometric functions through various examples, you can refer to the trigonometric functions differentiation video on my channel. How did you find today's video? If it was helpful, please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. This has been your math guardian, Alex.